singer Smokey, and players of instrument too.
Legalize it. Welcome to Cannabis Corner with Grandma Greenman
and Robert Porter
on KCAA 106.5 FM, 1050 AM, and 102.3 FM, teaching San Bernardino and the Inland Empire about local cannabis-related
issues.
Yes! Created by Greenman Entertainment.
And I love San Bernardino Productions.
Our call-in line, 1-888-909-1050, 1-888-909-1050. We like that.
All kinds of callers. Just call it.
Call in and talk crap if you want.
Yeah.
We like that.
Call in and tell me how ugly I am.
But you'll have to deal with Elmo and Tia Lisa afterwards, right? All right, we have Tia Lisa in the house today. All right.
Greetings.
Notice John will be playing for us later. And we have the veterans.
Weed for Warriors Project.
Weed for Warriors Project. Yes, and your name, sir?
Robert.
All right. I love that name. That's a great name.
Tell me about it.
Today's sponsor, Cold Creek Organics and Mark Estermeyer over there at 909-709-6000. They're right there at Palm and Highland.
Palm and Highland.
I actually just saw Mark Estermeyer.
You did?
Yes, we did.
We did.
Yes,
where
we did.
Where did we see him?
I saw him over there at the Highland City Council meeting.
We went to a Highland City Council meeting?
Yes, we went and represented Cannabis Corner and the
Brownie Mary. Democratic Club of San Bernardino County.
I love San Bernardino at the Highland City Council meeting where they were pretty much putting a ban on storefronts and things of that nature and highly regulating the personal use stuff. So.
Yes.
And they passed it, only one vote for...
Well, that was the second reading, right?
Yeah, so it's law now.
Okay.
Yeah, so it's law. So only there was two younger city council members that they're on board. One abstained this vote, but last time they voted yes. It's interesting that she mentioned San Bernardino and that a San Bernardino city council member called her to congratulate her on her tough stance on cannabis.
On her tough stance? No, not on her tough stance. On taking a stance and getting in front of it.
Well, that is the toughest stance in our area right now. I mean,
it's pretty strict.
So, who do you think would take the time to call Highland's mayor? I mean, it has to be a city council person who's on the border with Highland because that just seems logical.
Yes.
So we have two possibilities, right? We have Fred Charette and Bessine Littlefield Richard, 6th Ward councilwoman and 5th Ward,
fifth
right?
5th Ward.
Is do any
Fourth Ward, Fred.
Fourth Ward. Fourth Ward and 6th Ward. So which one, is that the only two that border it?
That border the city of Highland?
Yeah. So the whole thing is that our council people are in communications on cannabis.
And so which one of San Bernardino's council members would have called up Highland and said, good job for having tough regulations and getting ahead of the game before, before what?
Before
somebody goes out and gathers the 2,600 signatures required in Highland to put an initiative on a ballot.
Yeah,
which Mark Estermeyer explained.
Which will make Highland money because of the taxes that'll be coming back into the city.
And they just asked for law enforcement.
Yes, they were asking for more law enforcement officers at this same council meeting, but the council members are so blinded by marijuana, prohibition that they can't realize. Well, geez, even if we just had a test pilot program, that would be enough to hire 2-3 more officers and figure out if this is something that's good or bad for the city instead of just going off of fear-mongering and hyperbole. And
they even said that they needed more officers. It was so absurd to me that I gave a speech and said, hey, these are I didn't use cannabis in my speech.
Yes.
Specifically because they would have said that I was speaking on an item that's on the agenda
and
they would have shut me up. Mm-hmm. Right? So I've already dealt with this stuff at San Bernardino City Hall, so I know how to handle them. And what I did is I just basically said, hey, you have these revenue potentials and you're not utilizing them. And you're sending your patients to San Bernardino.
Yes.
And we already have issues. We have to take care of our own patients. So please, why? And honestly, in my mind, why would you send someone who might have a disability and may not be able to be mobile as a normal person who just drives around, send them to another city to get cannabis?
Send them to another more dangerous city to get their medicine.
Yes, I don't know. Highland's pretty dangerous. Well, so
I'm not trying to crap on San Bernardino in any way, but specifically for some people from Highland area,
they may feel that way.
They may exactly feel that way, that I'm having to go to scary San Bernardino in the ghetto, you know, to get my medicine. When I live in this nice neighborhood over here, why can't I just go down the street, like my neighbor is able to go to Walgreens and get her deadly, addictive, liver-killing drugs? And
the ladies that were speaking against cannabis look like they could probably use regulations on sugar. And I'm not lying.
Well, let's give thanks for Cold Creek being so close to Highland that they don't have to go too far into
Hope Mark doesn't get mad at me for saying, don't send your patients to San Bernardino.
Well, actually, he had brought that up in his three-minute
what
time.
What did he say, 43%?
I forget the specifics, but yeah. I believe it was 43% of his patients, his customer base, is Highland residents that come to San Bernardino to get their medicine.
Yeah, because he's so close. He's right there on the border, right there available for everybody, you know?
So,
we're always into something, aren't we,
yes.
Elmo? Wow, man. Well, call up Mark Estemeyer, let him know what's up, and if you want to go to more city council meetings and speak on cannabis, they have 3 minutes, just like our San Bernardino ones, and go on in before the meeting, enter your slip. We kind of entered afterwards, Elmo, so I think they were lenient with us.
Were they lenient, or were they just not as strict and stringent as San Bernardino trying to limit people's speaking ability?
Yeah, because they don't like free speech over there. You know, they want to make sure it's limited
to
3 minutes exactly.
They took my speaker slip. Cannabis issue was item 17 on the agenda. Mm-hmm. I turned in my slip while they were discussing item 16, and they accepted it.
And that was cool.
So.
And everybody listened, but they didn't really listen.
they don't really care. The law's already passed. It's happened, and they really want to stop talking about the issue.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. You know.
So basically, the word is San Bernardino's Measure O is going to go to court, and as soon as the judge decided whether it's constitutional or not with the zoning, then we'll know kind of the direction that we're going to go here in San Bernardino.
Yes.
Because then we'll petition to have Measure N, you know, put in its place.
Or something else. Or who knows?
Start a new initiative.
Who knows what's going to happen? Because from what I understand, there's four cases, correct, that the city is involved with four separate litigation cases.
I'm not sure about that,
this.
Really.
There's the people that say O is unconstitutional, and then there's the people that say O is.
You know? I see what you're saying. Like two opposing sides on each one.
Yes.
Okay.
And then N is saying we should be put in, and then there's another lawsuit saying N should be dismissed, you know, because they lost. You know, I may be wrong, but I believe that's what it is, that there's four separate cases.
And this is important, team. Don't be like, oh, we're bored, man. What are you talking about this stuff? No! We cannot do anything without this.
Right.
We can't do it. They'll send you. They're sending us to jail.
Right now.
They're locking us in cages, stealing our children, denying us housing, employment.
People that need medicine.
That's what it really, and I guess that's what I came down to at Highland, because it's kind of been weighing on me. So this really is a, how did I word it, would I say? A moral.
I know you called them bigots, and they didn't like that at all.
Well, a moral bigotry, and that's what it was, because the speaker before me, you know, they were not in favor of cannabis, and they were saying not all money is good money. But at the city council chambers, that says "In God We Trust" right there. So it's not all money is good money, depending on your point of view.
You want to get this caller, Elmo? You see what's going on?
We got a call. All right. We'll stop that and head right to the caller. Who's on?
Hey, caller.
How you doing?
Hey, how's it going?
Good. Good. This is Mike from Fontana.
Oh, yes.
Right on, Mike.
So why don't you give us a quick rundown what's going on with you? Because this is interesting, too.
Well, like so many of the San Bernardino County cities, it's a were proactive in their ordinance bans. Montana's had pretty zero tolerance for cannabis and dispensaries for quite a long time. I mean, they're very active with their paramilitary / police department. Well, last year, around August, they started passing an ordinance because they were with the assumption, and they were correct, that they were going to get ahead of Prop 64.
Right.
So they decided to ban any kind of dispensaries of any kind. They already have no medical now that they're going for no adult use. But they it took their time in crafting the regulations for what the one thing that they cannot ban, which would be personal home grows.
Right.
And they finally codified them, I think, in early this year, February past, I think. And they were fairly strict, and they're one of the first cities to come out with a very strict ordinance. And other cities have since followed suit. What makes Fontana unique is, not unique, but they were the first of the BBK family, you could say, to come out with a restrictive ordinance. When I say BDK, I'm referring to Best, Best and Krieger, the law firm that acts as their city attorney. Well, they are, you know, asking for things that basically end up being a de facto ban, that all of the requirements, the initial one being a $411 fee, plus you have to pay for your own criminal investigation on yourself, and also live fingerprinting. You're not allowed to build anything inside your home.
So they made these really, really strict requirements.
Are you even allowed to grow anything?
In Fontana. So how many people are actually following this, do you think? Do you think that how many people signed up for the background checks and the live scan? Does anyone have those numbers?
I have no idea. I imagine you'd have to do a Freedom of Information. But
it wasn't a line.
I would think, you know, if you were doing algebra, it might be a negative number.
All I can say is, you know, these cities are going to see the cities around them who have given regulations and given measures out there, and they're going to see these cities bringing in money and able to fix their roads and pay their officers and bring back programs to education, and they're going to get jealous and they're going to change because they're going to need that for their cities and want that for their cities, I think they're really going to regret their decision in this regard.
Absolutely, they will, because they're going to see that other cities are receiving revenues and adding to their police forces.
Yes.
Exactly.
Regulating the dispensaries properly and not having illegal ones pop up everywhere.
And in the meantime, cities like Fontana and possibly Highland and some other cities are going to end up, you know, San Bernardino, in litigation.
Yep.
Wasting money in the courts.
Giving money to lawyers.
Trying
about
to
economical growth as well. The housing, the houses, the prices will go up on the houses because, you know, everybody wants to be in a city where they can legally medicate, where they can have that and have that medication they need for whatever symptoms they have going on. So
I got a new idea for a brand new show right now.
What?
You know, like house flippers?
Yeah.
We're going to build grow rooms in the house. And so we're going to buy these rundown houses, videotape fixing them up and putting a grow room in it, and then see how much it sells for.
Right?
Very, very well.
Oh, we're going to get rich. All right. Well, I want to move into you guys because I don't want to lose the time because it just flies by here. But you have such a great project, and you have such great edibles. Oh my God, some of the best edibles in the world. So please, Robert, share with us what you do.
All right, so I'm the president of the Orange County chapter of the Weed for Warrior Project.
Woohoo!
So what the Weed for Warrior Project is a nonprofit organization that helps veterans get their alternative medicine.
Helps vets get weed?
Free.
Oh, see, I just spoke about my father's suicide. At Riverside National Cemetery with his Purple Heart in his hand, and I joked about the fact that I didn't. He asked me for cannabis, and I joked. My fault. But I won't let that happen again. I'm standing up for veterans now, and if they want to use cannabis like my father did in 1968 to get over PTSD, so be it.
Absolutely. Thank you. I appreciate that. That's important. I'm sorry about that. your loss.
Thank you, sir. We're learning together. I use it for strength now.
Yeps.
My father was a strong man. He was a war hero.
Digging it. And that's actually how I got into this was a couple of friends of mine had straight up told me these concoctions they were being fed. And at the age of 21, they were taking Viagra because of the pills that they were being fed. It was messing them all up. Their stasis, not homeo, just completely thrown off.
Mm-hmm.
And that really, really hurt me. And I knew cannabis was the way to go. And I literally was looking at their prescriptions label by label. I wish I could remember their names, but I can't. They're, diabolical
funny,
names
huh?
anyways.
They say that cannabis has short-term memory loss. But when you stop taking handfuls of pharmaceuticals every day, you start forgetting which ones that you took.
Exactly.
Well, you don't want to take. I was going through and just literally almost prescribing my friends types of flour and concentrates and edibles, and it's turned their lives around. I've seen many lives now be turned around in a matter of weeks because of the use of hemp and all of their.
And it's incredible.
Oh, absolutely.
Yes,
absolutely.
It is. It's not just the videos of the kids. That kid, they put the CBD on his feet and he stopped. It's not just that stuff.
No, it's not just that.
It's a whole range of things that you can't even see physically.
No.
Exactly.
Well, because if you look at the symptoms for PTSD, loss of sleep, which cannabis helps that mainly, anxiety, cannabis calms anxiety, aggravation, anger, things like that. Cannabis helps all of these things like cohesively across the board. So specifically for PTSD, this is an amazing medication.
And veterans,
they specialize
in PTSD,
exactly.
And they shouldn't have to.
No, they shouldn't.
Oh, man. Yeah, is there any veterans without PTSD? I really have a question. Is there any veterans without it? Is that possible? Is it possible to go to war and not have it after you left?
I'm sure it's possible, but I guess it depends on the makeup of the person. But I doubt that there's many.
Yeah,
right.
I mean, I bet we'll soon be able to see in the physical scarring on the brain. They'll take a picture of the brain before it goes to war and see
Absolutely.
What happens.
Yeah.
But my dad would always say he was not the same man when he came home.
No.
I mean,
no.
He couldn't see. He was totally blind. He has someone else's retina put it in, but because a landmine blew him up.
Mm.
So, like, even seeing that, one of his friends seeing that, they didn't even ever get hurt. Like, wouldn't that affect you forever?
Yeah.
I would think
yes,
so.
Yes, it would.
Absolutely.
And shouldn't they deserve medicine?
Yes, free
Absolutely.
Medicine.
Yeah, that really helps. Like,
safe access.
Natural.
they deserve to be able to grow as much as they want. I mean, if we're putting these guys really in a position where they're allowed to go, and let's put it blunt, they're allowed to send young men and women in
17.
Uniform over to foreign countries, tell them that these are our enemies, murder men, women, children, whatever it takes, do your job, do your duty.
And then not give them what they need to heal when they come back.
Not allow them to have access to a plant as benign as cannabis.
Yeah.
I mean...
Here, take Marinol that will just, throw you into sleep.
Let me feed you antidepressants that are going to make you crazy and suicidal. Oh, that one's not working. We'll get you off that one and put you on another one. Let's put you on another one. Here's all your pain medicine that's going to get you addicted. And then they meld all of these things together and think that somebody's not going to go crazy, even if they weren't already crazy.
Alcohol's
right.
already
you know
legal.
Mean?
They can just use that.
Oh, and then add alcohol to it. Yes, please, to all of the plethora of medications you're taking.
That's provided for you very, very inexpensively. Expensively at the store right down the street. That's the only one next to you because you're in the middle of the desert.
How many people, including veterans with PTSD, come home and they medicate with alcohol?
Mm-hmm. And it makes them angry.
Yes. And when they could just use cannabis, use a sativa in the beginning of the evening, don't go to sleep yet, just before bed, get an indica, go to bed, and...
Boom.
That's Absolutely. The way it's
and with
to
that, let's go to the call.
Oh,
we got another caller. We
love
callers.
Kala, what's your name?
It's Jim.
Hey.
How's it going?
What's up, Jim? How you doing, dude?
Hey. I'm doing all right.
Okay. Where are you calling from?
North end of San Bernardino.
Okay.
Kind of pocket. Just sitting around playing darts, listening to the show, and the good word that you pass around and all the good information.
Oh, we,
and you're
we
right.
appreciate that.
San Bernardino City Council has a set up a staff.
Beep! Beep! Oh, he got it, yeah! Well, well, thank you for noticing that, and it's not all of them. Now we got to give Benito Barrios some props, but our mayor Kerry Davis sometimes really needs to open his mind to some possibilities here.
Kerry Davis doesn't care about anything but his religion.
His own morality is what allows him to call everyone that he wants to a sinner that deserves whatever punishment that he can dole out to them.
The
mayor and the council needs to understand that the people need to be taken care of because it's an alternative to very, very deadly and dangerous painkillers and barbiturates.
Yes.
Well,
I for one have been there, and I don't want to be there again.
And we want to thank you for calling in, dude. I really appreciate that. And we want to encourage more callers out there. Call on in and let us know your story. We want to know if you're listening and playing darts. That's so cool.
Yes. So have you hit a hat trick yet tonight?
A hat trick?
Yes, three bulls.
Oh, no. Okay. No. We just play baseball on the board.
Have you hit a bull yet?
Not tonight, no. Oh, yeah, we did that.
Well, okay. All right, you got to hit a bowl and listen to Ganovis Corner. All right, brother, well, I'll talk to you later, all right?
All right, take it easy.
Cool.
Bong rips for Ganovis Corner.
And playing darts.
That sounds so cool, man.
Yeah, we encourage you all to play darts or whatever you want to play and listen to Ganovis Corner and
I
learn.
I haven't played darts for so long.
Maybe we can get a dartboard in here. All right, well, now you have an event coming up.
Absolutely.
Now let us know what's going down.
No Veterans Left Behind on the 24th in Santa Ana at Evergreens. That is a dispensary there. They will be hosting an event along with More Than Edibles with Tian.
Shiloh. Got this.
Yeah, Tian and Shiloh are More Than Edibles, and they are also hosting the event.
Okay.
Yeah, so what we did is we put this this event together with Evergreen, More Than Edibles, and of course Tia Lisa and Nana Potts are the main sponsors for the event. But we've gotten a lot of great vendors and media come out. You guys are going to be out there interviewing the veterans that we're having coming out. Christopher Lewandowski? He's going to be out there calling Ski.
And he's got a great story. I wouldn't say a great story because it's terrible that it happened.
But he's good now.
To a veteran in this country to have to go through what he did. It's a disgrace.
It is. And that's why everybody's so glad to kind of get behind what we're doing. We're giving out free recommendations for every veteran that comes that doesn't have one and like to be a part. It's a very educational event, so if this is their first time, we really welcome them to come, learn about how this can help, what they have going on in their life at the moment. We're giving out 250 free bags of product full of everybody's stuff. Cookies are going to be there. Guild Extracts, Apothecana, Humboldt Vapes, Marion's Hope is going to be there.
Weed.
And they're really, really big in the CBD.
Did you hear that? Free weed?
The address is 1320
veterans.
East Edinger in Santa Ana.
So
Free food, free
and
weed,
and free DJ. Swag bags.
Free swag bags
filled with weed and with cannabis weed, products.
Shirts, Father Keith, swag.
All for veterans.
All for veterans, and then it's a family event as well. So if you want to bring your sisters, brothers, wives, the recommendations for everybody else are only going to be $35. So bring everybody you can. Let's go and get some education. Let's get these veterans some free medicine, and that's our goal with that. Just kind of pushing that out.
Man, they should already be getting it from the government.
Pretty much. And there's a couple people that do.
But unfortunately, I don't think they're veterans.
That's the sad part.
Yeah. So sad. All right. Well, you want to give a number that can get a hold of you guys?
Sure. Yeah, if you'd like to get a hold of More Than Edibles, you can call 909-520-9196. That is my cell phone. If you have any questions or you want to RSVP for VIPs. Right. Any veteran can RSVP for the VIP. So just give me a call and you get more free stuff if you just let me know your name. You can also email me at morethanedibles@gmail.com. All of your name, anybody you want to bring, information, I'll make sure that we get you in there in VIP status.
Sounds good. It sounds great awesome. For our vets.
Yeah.
And then if you want to join Weed for Warriors and you're a warrior and you want to be a part of that organization, you can contact Robert as well.
Absolutely. My contact number is 815-666-4974. And you can get a hold of me at Weed for Warrior Project or OC Gmail.
There you go.
Shiloh, Robert, thank you so much for coming on here. We right. really appreciate it.
Yes, we do.
Good
so
luck
much.
With your event. That sounds dope.
Thank you so much
and
for having
remember,
us.
We're going to be there. So.
Oh, well, I guess I'm going to be there. Yeah, you never know, man. You never know with me. It's like
it's going to be pretty big. The Weed Show's coming. Dub Magazine's coming. Dope Magazine's coming. Weed Maps will be there. We have OC Weekly that's going to be there.
Oh, really?
It's a very big media event. We want to get as much people into it and know that there's companies out there and cannabis companies out there that care about they care about their community, they care about their veterans, and they would love to help. So it's not all about greed. And I
they
think
care
that
about
think that.
They care about humans. They care, yeah, yes. They care about humans.
Exactly.
And it, weed makes you more compassionate.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
I'm not lying.
It does.
Try some. All of a sudden
Come
you'll
on,
be like,
City Council members.
I love you. Instead of I hate you.
Interesting.
All right, should we hit a break or should
Sounds
we roll
like
it?
A
all right,
great
we'll hit
time.
A break for some pictures. Cannabis Corner will be back in a few.
Awesome.
Say finally, this naughty dread can smoke in a peace. No have to take no offense from no police. I man was waiting, I was praying, I was hoping for the days like these. Say finally, yeah, naughty dread can smoke in a peace. No have to take no offense from no police. I man was waiting, I was praying, I was hoping for the days like these. Remember when me used to have a stuff it in my socks or my shoes. Come and ever want me mama see me pan now news. That holy sacrament it truly changed my views. From the very first draw, inspiration I owes. The marijuana plant ain't just another plant. Made me forget all my cares and mother ain't all my wants. Them say it make you rebel, rebel against what? Babylon schemes and plots. But finally, this naughty dread can smoke in a peace. I mean no have to run from no police. I man was waiting, I was praying, I was hoping for the days like these. Say finally, yeah, naughty dread can smoke in a peace. I mean no have to run from no police. I man was waiting, I was praying, I was hoping for the days like this. So drop up a drop in the commissioner. And another feminist star. Drop up a jar for the doctors. And another one for me lawyer. Come finally, this naughty dread can smoke in a peace. I mean no have to run from no police. I man was waiting, I was praying, I was hoping for the days like these. Say finally, yeah, naughty dread can smoke in a peace. I mean no have to run from no police. Hey, Tosh was waiting, him was praying, him was hoping for the days like these. Sensimilia, indica and sativa, I call them my dream weavers. Remove the veil from my eyes, eyes, eyes. Sensimilia, indica and sativa, I call them my dream weavers. Remove the veil from my eyes, now I can smoke in a peace. I mean no have to run from no police. I man was waiting, I was praying, I was hoping for the days like these. Say finally, yeah, naughty dread can smoke in a peace. I mean no have to run from no police. Hey killa mila, he was waiting, he was praying for the days like these.
Bye.
Hey, Inland Empire, welcome back to Cannabis Corner. I would like to thank our sponsor, Kasha Harrington, and with Rehab Delivery TV up there in the high desert. Give them a call, 1-760-953-9353. And I'd also like to thank our local advocate on cannabis, Rowe, and she's always involved in helping the community. And she works with the 420 Wellness Center located at 1177 Northeast Street in San Bernardino. All right, so now...
Let me mention this, too, this event tomorrow.
Oh, yes, please.
So tomorrow I'm going to be DJing at 15520 7th Street in Victorville, the High Desert Hotbox. Remember that event?
Yes, yes.
So they've moved to this new venue here, 15520 7th Street in Victorville. They're going to be having a Joke and Toke Wednesdays.
Aww.
So hosted by Stoner Rob. Yeah, from the Improv and Laugh Factory Comedy Store and such. And
you got lucky it's not on a city council day.
So there's going to be a bunch of vendors. I'm going to be DJing, food, lots of seating. There's going to have seats. This is not going to be one of those events where you have to walk around and be on your feet all day. It's a joke and toke. It's a comedy show.
Are you going to put on a performance?
No, I'm going to be the DJ that performs in between sets and at dull times and whatnot. But it's only $5 at the door, and it's 18 and over with a rec, 21 and over with your ID.
Okay. So. All right, well, we have Notice Young, who's going to be performing for us in a second. But first we got Ryan Marks in Deal of the Week, and then we got Crystal Trimmer here visiting with us.
Woo!
Just chime in whenever she wishes.
Well, hello there.
How you doing there, Deal of the Week?
What's going on? Welcome.
FontanaCoupons.com.
Yes, guys. If you can, go to www.FontanaCoupons.com to check out all the monthly deals that we have. This week, I was cruising around, and actually, I bumped into you guys at the taco sesh there on last Saturday. And, I want to give a shout-out to a group of gentlemen that I've met at Higher Standard Organics. They have some delicious products, you guys. Some of their wax, their shatters, and some of their, their live resin is absolutely phenomenal. So if you guys look for them at some of these taco sesh, they're going to be out there tomorrow night. And at the Saturday sesh, check them out on Instagram. Like them, higher.standard.organics. Absolutely phenomenal products. So check them out. Also, I want you guys to know that each week Fontana Coupons comes on to Cannabis Corner, and we look for different businesses to showcase their products. So if you guys have a business or a product that you guys would like to get out to the cannabis world, feel free to contact myself, Ryan Marks, at ryan@fontanacoupons.com. You can go to my Facebook. You can message me there. Or you guys could just give me a phone call. My number is 909-520-1040. So again, if you want to showcase a product or a business on Deal of the Week here on Cannabis Corner, feel free to give me a shout out.
That will too.
All right.
Guys, thank you. Everybody have a wonderful, blessed week, and stay high.
As we move in, speaking of the event on Wednesday, that Taco Sesh MC Life and the Taco Sesh team threw an incredible event.
It was great.
That was San Bernardino's finest sesh I've seen in a long time, dude. Mm-hmm. But sesh style,
Sesh. Yeah.
Not a full festival, but it was.
Right.
But seriously, they had that whole building filled. That was real good work.
Yes, good job.
And thank you for inviting us and letting us go. And we felt like a star. And we want to thank MC Life and the whole team. And stay tuned for IE Radio coming on right after Cannabis Corner at 9 o'clock.
Lovely.
Now, we did see you over there, Mr. Young. So,
Notice Young.
Yeah, so
yes, sir.
You performed as well.
Yeah,
right?
I performed with MC Life. That's the good homie of mine too. Shouts out to him once again.
Yeah, I think actually he was the one that introduced us back in the day.
Right. Yeah, that's how I got on the first Cannabis Corner last time too.
And Elma was happened to be working up in the high desert that day or something.
Yeah, he was.
Yeah.
It's finally good to meet you, Domin.
Yes.
Right on. So you came with some, prepared with some beats for us today, right?
Yeah, I have a little acapella for you guys and a song I wanted to preview. I have an album coming out called BRB, which stands for Bless Right Back. And yeah, okay. It's just one of the songs that's part of it. I wanted to show to you guys and to everybody else tuning in.
All right, cool.
Awesome.
Cool.
Right. And yeah, before that, I'll spit a little acapella if that's okay with you guys.
All right, cool. That's whatever you want to do, dude.
Yeah. Separated from this world full of hatred. Smoked all my grass so I can see where the snakes live. Quick to gather up my folks for this protest. Peace signs, but we can take it there now if you want it. Yeah. Take a shot and I'll forget about. My marijuana count has exceeded just to tune you out. Some be scared to take a leap, but quick to show they feeling froggy now. But oddly, I'll dismiss these misguided childs. Ain't getting paid overtime for babysitting. Y'all really getting in the way of this road that I was destined to. Step foot in both boots on the pavement. Ain't here to toot my own horn, but recognition is deserved from you to me, though. And that's putting it lightly before you try and refer to my ego. Until my compensation equals up to 100 C-notes. Ain't taking nothing less or whatever even just seems close. Not a damn thing changed, we still do it for the love. Hell, we love it enough to know what's worth and fight for every buck. Can give a what, whether you with us or not. In the end, this is all we got. Yeah, we are all we got. One more time, I go by Notice Young, and here's the song.
All right.
Oh, thank you, man.
I like that. That
yeah.
Was,
thank you, I appreciate it. Shouts out to Sam Beats on the beat.
What up, Robert?
What's up, dude?
Yeah.
Money, I ain't have enough yet. Still pay some bills with this petty ass check. Funny how I pile up these debts. Work to repay till I ain't got a dime left. But I ain't living no less. No need to stress. What else but giving my best? Know that I'm blessed. But I ain't living no less. No need to stress. What else but giving my best? Know that I'm blessed. Yeah, travel across the globe. Wish I could say that now. Put a gavel in the cork on this side, when I'm destined to go down. Handle what you think I deserve, don't trip, I won't run out. Got a couple more good years on earth, I'll figure out my route. To a stable living, but satisfaction won't equal to it as it should. And can't live stagnant if I'm able to do what I manage. Take my baggage if you can't get past anything. Maybe some weight off when I lift off, gon' get me to my dream. Yeah, yeah, let me do my thing right now. I ain't waiting no more till you will allow me to sing about my pain real loud. Say what you want, but you won't close my mouth. Yeah, yeah. Regardless, I'ma live. If y'all don't got, I'll get. Regardless, I'ma live. If y'all don't got, I'll give. Soon as I'll handle all my biz. Money, I ain't have a lot, yeah. But no better feeling than to give my mama some so she can flex. But me, I don't feel with these debts. If I got it, no, we eating till there ain't a thing left. And we ain't living no less, no need to stress. What else but give it our best, know that we blessed. We ain't living no less, no need to stress. What else but give it our best, know that we blessed. Yeah, blessed be the name of where my praying to. I asked about 1,000 times, I ain't had a clue. But me relying on somebody I never knew. Seems wild, I ain't hoping for nothing I'ma do. What I know needs to be done, but that don't mean me humdrum. Quite often I ask if you gon' run with me or stay away from. Who says we can't have fun just cause we ain't got the funds? We gon' show him it ain't, if it ain't involving them. Yeah, let me do my thing right now. I ain't waiting no more till you will allow me to sing about my pain real loud. Say what you want, but you won't close my mouth. Yeah, yeah. Regardless, I'ma live. If y'all don't got, I'll give. I'ma live. If y'all don't got, I'll give. Soon as I'll handle all my biz.
Awesome. I'm glad you guys liked it, man. Thank you. Once again, I go by Notice Young. And yeah, that's off the next project that's coming up called BRB.
How'd they get right a hold back of your work?
So my name, the way you spell it is Notiz space Yong. And if you just kind of Google that, all the SoundCloud, Twitter, and other social medias will kind of pop up as well.
Okay. So, awesome, yeah, awesome.
That's the easiest way.
Easiest way.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I seen a couple of your posts today. It started off a little on the wrong side of the bed, but then I saw them perk up.
Oh, definitely.
I love watching the performers post, man. They're so funny. Yes. They make me crack up, believe me.
But yeah, it was a little rocky day. I mean, it's been a rocky week. Got fired last week. Not to, you know, bug you with all my stresses and stuff.
Do you want to tell your ex-boss anything on here? You know?
Nah, it's all good. I still need to collect my unemployment, so I ain't trying to make anything sour yet. But
okay.
Yeah. But yeah, I mean, aside from that, you know, it's more time for music. You just got to look at the positive side of it.
What'd you think, Crystal the Trimmer?
Yeah.
Thank you. I appreciate it. Thank you.
You got good beats, dude. Yes. Now, you said you might. Did you have three? Did you have possibility of one more here?
Low key, I didn't know how much time I was gonna have, but
I mean, it's all good to us. I mean, we can go on to have a few more things we can talk about, but if you'd like to do one more, you're welcome to.
Yeah, I mean, if you want to, you want me to go give him some more beats.
Yeah, give him one more, and I'll move on to this thing real quick. All right.
Cool. All right, thank you, man. So we're gonna get back to some music, but a little information interlude.
Yeah, a little information interlude, and you know, it's unfortunate that you know, today Jeff Sessions was in court, our U.S. Attorney General. They were asking him about his Russia connections and things like that. But the prior day, like to wag the dog, there came out an article that talks basically about Sessions asked our Congress to end all the medical cannabis protections. He wants to make sure that he has all the laws at his disposal if he wishes to go after anybody involved in drugs or anything criminal in the United States of America. So he hates cannabis and considers it 100% criminal, so he wishes to be able to treat it as such.
Doesn't he own stocks in private prisons?
He is a dumb butt. And he, well, unfortunately, he sounded...
It's not too dumb to go after and criminalize the easiest people to round up and throw into your private prison for you to make money. That's not dumb. That's how, you know, somebody like him makes millions.
No, I didn't say dumb. I said dumb butt. Well, basically what it means to me is that this dude, it still thinks if you're a cannabis user, you're no good. And he said it. There is no such thing as a good cannabis user, and he means it. Now, if you're under some impression that Trump's going to jump on the medical bandwagon and help everybody, I haven't seen it yet. I really haven't. Mm-mm. I want to. I haven't seen it. So if you're a Republican and you voted this guy in there, man, you're dealing with him. Now, I'm not saying Republicans are bad. They sponsor our show right here.
Yes,
right?
They do.
But what I'm saying is that you got to watch who you put into office here. That not necessarily just because he said something in 1970 doesn't mean that he's still going to do it today. I don't trust Trump. I just don't.
If you hear a little crunching over my mic, it's I'm mowing down on some of this.
Just the Elisa.
Yeah, these are my favorites.
They're good stuff. So basically, if you want to find out more about this, you can check out Jeff Sessions. Now, there's one more thing that we can go over really quickly. Oregon just had their first federal case basically against the federal government when it involves legalized cannabis. And what they're trying to say is that Oregon produces more cannabis than the amount of people that use it,
right,
and they're distributing it all over the United States against international drug trafficking laws, and they want it to stop.
Well, so, somewhat that's good regulation, right? It shows that their seed-to-sale tracking system works. They're finding out that cannabis is leaving their state.
Yeah, but for me, wouldn't it just be easier to legalize it fully across the whole United States and not have to worry about it?
It's easier for us. for the opposition, legalize that's the hardest it. Thing in the world to do. You know?
So basically, Oregon's fighting that battle for us right now, and we'll see how it turns out, but it's looking like they're just going to make more stringent regulations. And honestly, I don't believe we should be going that way.
Yes and no. If it's adding more stringent regulations on
pesticide or something like that, yeah.
Well, not only that, but on the corporate entities, I suppose.
That ain't going to happen. It's going to be the opposite. It's
right.
Gonna be
so that's what they're doing. They're saying they're growing so much weed in Oregon. They're growing so much weed in Oregon. We have to cut how much the private citizen is allowed to grow, but this guy over here with the 4-acre warehouse just keep on doing what you're doing because you're paying us taxes. And
so. Now, I know all this doesn't make sense, and it's going to take court case to court case to court case to battle to battle to battle, and we're just going to keep you informed, and you make your own decisions. But right now in California, I'd work on getting your permits.
Yes.
You know, work on getting your local permit, work on getting your state permit. That's a lot of work and a lot of money. It's not cheap. You're going to have to find investors unless you got a big back pocket.
Something.
So get to work right now. Don't wait. Get the paperwork done. If you're really that interested, get it done. But hold on to it, especially if you're in San Bernardino trying to get a local license. But if you're in Adelanto, go for it.
Go for it.
If you're in the high desert, there's a few.
Go for it. There's a lot of places in the high desert that are starting to open up to regulation. Also, out Cathedral City, Desert Hot Springs. So it's moving along.
Okay, well, before we get to our last performance, I wanted to mention that Crystal Trimmer will be coming on again with, hopefully, with Amethyst.
Yes.
And they'll be talking about a lady's point of view of the cannabis trimming industry.
Okay.
And yeah, I'll be looking forward to it. Yeah.
You do all kinds of stuff, right?
Yes. I just don't trim them. I also transplant, clone. I could do quite a bit, the whole nine yards, to go ahead and get it running from the veg to the time it's ready.
My awesome. Hero! Yes. She makes sure that cannabis is trimmed for you.
Yes.
And growing good.
Yes.
All right, Mr. Young, please.
Oh, yeah. So, yeah, the next song is just something I like to have fun with. Some people might recognize it. Do you guys know a group called Farside?
Yes, yes.
Anybody? All right, it's one of their songs called Other Fish, and I just like the beat a lot and how it vibe. Yeah. In the sea, that is. You know there's other fish in the sea, that is. You know there's other fish in the sea, that is. You know there's other fish in the sea. Wouldn't be right if I don't speak of what is really on my mind. Either that or this song would be a lie. Shouldn't rely on anybody in my life. Kinda pride sure had me outcasted for the nights. My only light was just this blunt that spark. While laughing at these races that's afraid of the dark. Silly stereotypes for you to barge in our car trying to Spartan and make. Hold on. Hey, my bad. My homie just walked in. I know you just.
You do have a brain fart. Ow!
Hey, shouts out to MC Life, man. It's all good. It's all good.
Got distracted.
Could I just spit that acapella without the beat real quick?
When stars walk in the building, that's what
I was just a little starstruck, you know. Shouts out to MC Life one more time.
Yeah, five more minutes and we got IE Radio coming on. All right. Well, that was do you want to.
Sure. I'll spit a little bit.
Alright.
Check it. Wouldn't be right if I don't speak of what is really on my mind. Either that or this song would be a lie. Shouldn't rely on anybody in my life. Kinda pride sure had me outcasted for the nights. My only light was just this blunt that sparked. While laughing at these races that's afraid of the dark. Silly stereotypes you hold them forced to come barge in her car. Trying to change the station, get scarred. Man, I miss those days. Wildin' with the homies, only goal was to make sure we all get faded. May we all get laid. Much simpler times. Good to see they moving on, but seems I'm falling behind. Last time I heard from, not the last time I heard about him. One off drugs, one getting married, the others with my ex dating. He's the same one that told me, young, you gon' make it. Still appreciate it, even if there was no love behind it. I overlooked the other motive, but if I'll just keep it at that. Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you for not saying any bad words.
Oh, yeah, of course. I made sure.
All right. Well, that was clean and with a little interruption, but seriously, dude, keep on going. We're going to have you on again, and I appreciate that you represent cannabis the way you do.
Yeah, definitely.
I mean, it takes a lot to come out of the closet. Really, what we've all done is come out of the closet, the cannabis closet.
Mm-hmm. Cannabis closet.
All right, well, should we end with a quick history roach clip?
Yeah, a history roach clip.
All right, we'll start here. People in the Western world use scientific name from then on until in the revolution. The first revolution of the 20th century, the Mexican Revolution, which began in 1910, with war come refugees. Mexican peasants fled north into the United States. They took cannabis with them, but they didn't call it cannabis. They called it marijuana. In 1914, a wave of anti-marijuana legislation kicked in. It started in the border towns. The push for federal ban on marijuana started in the 1930s. Banning and controlling marijuana made it easier to control migrant populations,
what?
Already subject to racist bigotry. So we call it marijuana to scare ourselves into oppressing immigrant workers fleeing political upheaval and banning a useful plant. We call it cannabis again now to gain a new legitimacy. Rather than a long foreign word spoken by the good people of Mexico, we need a word that traveled from the dead language of the Germanic and Romantic languages to feel more comfortable. But don't worry about this too much. Pot, grass, weed, herb, bud, dope, boob, call it whatever you want. Worry more about the political howlers. Ooh. And that's kind of his history, Roachcliffe.
That's, you know what, I like that.
Yes.
Yes, it's very important for us to understand that the term marijuana is a bit racist.
Yes.
It has a racial connotation to it, and it was a lot to do with Pancho Villa and his raids across the United States. You know that how often has that actually happened in our history? I actually think that's pretty strong to be able to do something like that, but they used cannabis against them and they made them look very bad,
mm-hmm.
and that's why we have the song, La Cucaracha.
Yeah,
I'm not going to sing it this time, but I have sung it on Cannabis Corner before, and we will go over that again in the future, because that's a really cool story, too, the history of La Cucaracha. No marijuana que fumar. All right, before we end this, I want to thank Tia Lisa and the Weeds for Veterans.
Weeds for Warriors project.
And
the No Veterans Left Behind
event
coming up.
And yell that date again. June 24th, okay,
and Evergreen Santa Ana.
And
make sure you'll see it on our post. We're gonna make sure to put all the information, because it's a great event. We can't wait to go.
So please go to the website, FontanesCoupons.com.
Yes.
Go to Facebook page, Cannabis Corner, or I Love San Bernardino, or
the San Bernardino Cannabis Concerns and Reforms Group,
or Green Men Entertainment.
Green Men Entertainment, and of course, like and follow the Cannabis Corner Facebook page, where you can just click that watch video button every week and see the latest episode of Cannabis Corner as recorded through Ustream.
And always follow Anota Zhang and Crystal the Tremor on Instagram.
Follow us.
MC Life is next with IE Radio, Cannabis Corner. Ow!
Yeah, and I will advertise. KCAA Loma Linda, 1050 AM, 106.5.